So guys, I hope you are learning great. And in this video, we are going to learn about NiFi provenance data and how you can pull that provenance data to create your own custom report. So just a quick revisit of provenance repository. So provenance repository is where the history of each flow file is stored. So during the course, we have seen many times that whenever we see flow files in the queue, we always view the content of those flow file. And if you just see next to flow file, we have something called provenance. Okay, so next to the option where you see view content, you have something called provenance. And if you click on the provenance, it is going to provide you the history of that flow file. So basically it gives you very important details like date and time and the operation which has been performed, along with the each step which has been taken in that flow file. Okay, so as you can see in the NiFi documentation, it clearly states provenance repository is where the history of each flow file is stored, and this history is used to provide data lineage functionality. So whenever you want to see what are all the action which has been taken on your file from source until the target, you can always use or you can always refer to provenance repository data. Now the format in which provenance repository data is stored is on the file system, and it is something which is cannot be directly queried. Okay, so the way to pull that data is, okay, before we do that, let me show you where the provenance data is stored. So let me clear the screen, and currently I'm in NiFi directories conf directory, so I'm going to go one level back. And if I do ls here, you can see we have a directory which is called provenance repository. Okay, this is the directory we have. So inside this directory, you can do ls, and you see we have many gzip directory, and also we have something called provenance files. So this is something which is, you know, not known to, or which is something which you cannot directly query on, or you cannot directly see the data. So it is NiFi way of storing provenance related data here. We are not going to do anything directly here. I will let you know what is the way how you can actually pull all the provenance related data. And before we move on to the action, let's see what is the data which is stored in provenance repository. Okay, so if you see, this is the data which is stored in the provenance repository, and it is event ID, event ordinal, event type, lineage start, details. So as you can see, it has almost all the details which is required for a audit purpose of any a flow file, or any, and if you want to see the lineage of any flow file. So now how you enable this data? So the way to do that is, so there are two or three things which we need to take care. In this case, we are going to use site-to-site provenance reporting. Okay, so there is something called site-to-site provenance reporting, which we are going to use in this case to pull all the report of provenance data. Now, as the name states, when you do site-to-site provenance reporting, actually you are transferring data from one NiFi site to another NiFi site. Okay, so it is more like you are transferring data from source NiFi to a destination NiFi instance. Okay, so whenever you are transferring data from source to destination, you need details of source and you need details of destination NiFi. Okay, that is a typical use case. But however, in this case, we do not want to transfer our data to a destination NiFi. All we want to do is we just want to pull a provenance related data. So what we are going to do is, in source NiFi and destination NiFi, we are going to keep the same NiFi instance. The other thing is, whenever you are transferring data from source to destination, you need destination, the destination should be having a way or a mechanism to handle all the incoming data. So for that one, destination NiFi instance requires an input port. Okay, so I had already created a port. I'm going to disable it and let's delete it because I want to show you how all of these steps are done. Okay, so first thing we are going to do is let's use an input port and let's give it a name. So I'm going to give it a name of provenance data. Okay, since it is going to accept all the provenance data, so I have named it provenance data. And now let's just connect it to log message. I'm just going to use log message as a placeholder. We are not going to make any changes here in the log message. So, and also connect provenance data to log message. Okay, so we have created our input port on which data is going to be sent. Now the next thing which we need to do is go to the global menu and go to the control settings, and in the control settings under the reporting task we need to create a reporting task which is called site to site provenance reporting task. So let me delete this one and let me show you how we can create this. Okay, so when you log into reporting task for the first time, you will be seeing a blank window something like this. Then you click on the plus symbol to create a new reporting task, and here you can type site, and then you will be seeing something like site to site provenance reporting task. So click on add, and then in this one we need to make some of the configuration changes. So I'm going to click on this tiny edit symbol or pencil symbol. Okay, so when you open this, you can see in the instance URL, this is the source instance URL. Okay, so we were discussing about here that we need a detail of a source NiFi and a destination NiFi instance. Okay, so by default, NiFi already picks up instance URL, which is the source instance URL. And now we need to give a destination URL. So as I told you, in this case, we are going to use the same URL. So I'm just copy pasting same URL here in the destination URL. Now in the input port, we need to provide the name of the input port which we have just created. If you remember, I have created an input port with name provenance underscore data. So I have provided that name, and then we have something called batch size. So usually provenance data is huge in numbers, and you would usually want this data to be collected in a batch and then to be sent. So if I keep it to 1000, there will be 1000 records will be sent in each batch. So just for the purpose of demonstration, I'm going to make it only 10. And that's probably it. I'm not going to make any other changes here. The only change which I will make is in the settings. In the settings, let's change the scheduling from 5 minutes to 1 minute. Okay, as we just this is just a development environment and we want to see our data frequently, so I have changed from 5 minutes to 1 minute. Probably in production you can keep it default 5 minutes. And now let's click on apply. Okay, I don't know what this screen is. This looks like something is stuck. Okay, so that's all. Currently, this is in stopped state. Now we can start it, but there's one more configuration which you need to do before you start it. Okay, so as the name states, this is going to transfer data from source to destination. So it is site to site reporting task. So your destination should be having a listening port, or should be having a port, okay, a physical port on which data is going to be transmitted. So I will close this. So this is the input port, which was like a logical port. Okay, this has nothing to do with a physical port or actual port or communication port which is required to be opened on the server. Okay, however, whenever you are transferring data from source to destination, you need a port which is listening for the data. Okay, so we need to make some changes in the configuration file of destination NiFi. In this case, our source and destination NiFi is going to be same. So I'm going to log into my NiFi instance. Let me clear the screen. So currently we are into Provenance repository. I'm going to go back and I'm going to go into conf directory. So as you can see, my present working directory is configuration directory. So now if I do ls, I should be seeing a file which is called nifi.properties. So I'm going to open this nifi.properties file in a VI editor. And now we need to make changes under the section of site to site properties. Okay, so just make sure you are making changes under site to site properties. And in NiFi remote input host, provide the host name. And host name should be a fully qualified host name. So the way to find a fully qualified host name on Linux is you type command which is called hostname space hyphen f. It is going to give you a fully qualified hostname of your server. Okay, so you paste that hostname here, and in the nifi.remote.input.secure, set it to false, and in nifi.remote.input.socket.port, change it to 1001. Okay, this is something which I have given because I was not I was knowing that there is no other application which is running on this port, but you need to set it. You can change it to any port number, just make sure there is no other application which is using that port. Okay, and in nifi.remote.input.http enabled, set it to true, and remaining other things you can leave it to default. So these are the default values. I haven't made any changes here. So the only changes which you need to make are in these four categories or in these four properties. So after that, you save the changes. And then remember, whenever you make any changes in nifi.properties file, you always need to restart your instance. So I have already made these changes in the nifi.properties file, and I had restarted NiFi instance before starting this course. So I do not need to make these changes again, or I don't require NiFi to be restarted. Okay, so that's only the one-time configuration which you have to do. So remember, there are three things which we have done so far. One thing is we have created an input port, and then we have created site to site reporting task, and then we have made configuration changes in destination NiFi configuration file. Okay, so once you do these three steps, now you are good to go. So what I'm going to do is, let's first start this input port. And if I refresh, currently you see there is no data which is incoming here. The reason is, if you go to the global menu and go to the controller settings, if you see, we have not started our site-to-site provenance reporting task. So let me start this task. Okay, as we can see now, the run status has changed to running. So now I'm going to close this. And now we should be waiting for our data here. Okay, as you can see, data has already came here. So we have received around 99 flow files. and I'm going to right click and select list queue. And now let's see content of the flow files. So each of the flow files are going to have 10 records in this case, because if you remember, we had set the properties to 10 records in a batch. And the data is by default is in JSON format. So I'm going to select view as formatted. And as you can see, we have received 10 records. Okay, so these are provenance data which we have here. So you can see event ID, you see event ordinal, you see the event type. So you see all the historical information about the action which has been performed on the flow file. Okay, this is a very useful information when you want to perform or you want to save audit related information of a flow file. And now once you have data in JSON format, now you can play with the data. You can probably store in a file, or if you want to format it, or if you want only selected attributes, then you can combine this task with other processors to select only the required attributes which you need, or required, so basically the required data you need. So that's all I wanted to demonstrate to you. Hope the session was clear. If there is any confusion, please feel free to write me, and I'll be more than happy to clarify any doubt.